Gill. Good evening.
Good evening, everyone. So in the joint stand before you, to testify the things that y'all we have revealed on the website here. One of the things that we always like to make known to you that are here, maybe you're here for the first time, we always like to make known that this is a school. We come here to learn of the things of God which we have revealed. We said that because this teaching is not from a man, but it's of God. Now, a few weeks back, I thought that the satanic spirit or the devil does not have the Holy Spirit. Neither does everybody have the Holy Spirit. About 3 weeks ago, Dr. Glenn Kennedy, he was on board, he said that everybody has the Holy Spirit, including the devil. Now, I thought maybe tonight I would take part of the time and explain what I was talking about, and then I would give over to him and then let him explain what he's talking about. Because a lot of times when you explain things and you really get down into it, sometimes you're not as far apart as you sound.
That's right.
And so that's the reason why, because as God always told us, he said, now, make prove things and make things simple. Right. Keep things where people can understand. And so when Dr. Ben Hill made a statement, he did not explain why he said what he did say.
That's right.
So for that reason tonight, then I'll take part of time and then give over the way, because I can't let him have the rest of the time and he explained what he was saying, because I'm quite sure he has a reason for saying what he did. Okay, now, to get into this, we're talking about the Holy Spirit, or sometimes it's referred to as the Holy Ghost. Now, to get into it, back in the antediluvian age, or we're saying post-diluvian age here, then when Yahweh, in his divine purpose and plan, he brings a nation of people which he had already had brought down into Egypt, then he brings that nation of people up out of Egypt through the divine water which he into the wilderness of Sinai here. And they get into the wilderness of Sinai, then Yahweh called Moses on up into the top of this mountain here, and when Moses entered into the top of the mountain, the symbolic, he ran in eternity with Yahweh there. And while he's in this state, then it's revealed that he revealed unto Moses how he brought this creation in, according to his own divine pattern and plan. Now when he brought it in, Moses in this vision, and seeing the vision of the creation of heaven and earth coming forth, coming from Yahweh, then he also saw the man being created. And when he saw that man being created, he said in that picture there, then he said that man was created from the dust of the earth. And then Yahweh breathed the breath of life into that man. Then he became a living soul. And it was revealed unto us, or talked to us by the mountain, that when the man came forth then, the man is body, and his soul, and his spirit.
That's right.
Okay, now it's confirmed. When you get over there in the Thessalonians, I think it is, it's confirmed in the book of Thessalonians that Paul is writing to the Thessalonians, say, I pray that your whole soul, body, and spirit be preserved. Mm-hmm. So then it's revealed then that mankind is threefold because he is made after the image and likeness of a heavenly Father, which is the Father, the Word, and the Holy Spirit. These three are one, then it's confirmed by mankind, a man coming forth, and that man is body, soul, and spirit. Now, since he's body, soul, and spirit, then when we'll get into it like this. When Yahshua the Messiah, give me John, so-called St. John, 7:37. Talk about 7:37.
John 7:37.
And also pick up for me in Joel 2:28. Now remember now, said now, this man come forth and he created it, and Moses saw it. This man coming forth, he is in, created in the likeness of the heavenly Father, which is by his own spirit. Now then, since he's having the spirit, right after he was created, mankind is talking about. Now then, in the book of Joel, we read in Joel first. Then here's what the prophet is speaking, or that is to say, the spirit is speaking through Joel.
Joel 2:28.
Mm-hmm.
And it shall come to pass afterward.
Now when you say it shall come to pass, the meaning that it has come in. And it shall come to pass. Read.
Afterward,
mm-hmm.
that I will pour out my spirit.
That I will pour out my spirit. Now who's doing speaking here? It's not Joel doing it. It's Yahweh doing the speaking, and he's speaking through the prophet Joel. And really, Joel's not a prophet, but it was sent here a prophet, because they foretell the event that is yet to come. Now he said, and it shall come to pass, that what?
That I will pour out my spirit.
That Yahweh said, then, that I will pour out my spirit. Read.
Upon all flesh.
Mm-hmm. And upon all flesh. Read.
And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy.
Mm-hmm.
Your old men shall dream dreams.
I said that your old men shall dream dreams. Read.
Your young men that shall see visions.
Okay. That's being prophesied in the book of Joel. Now it was Joshua the Messiah, who is Yahweh manifested in the physical form. This is that sacrificial body that Yahweh prepared for himself to manifest in. Then when he comes on the scene, in John 7:37, pick it up, read that please.
John 7:37.
Okay, he says it's 27 in the Holy Name Bible.
In the last day, mm-hmm. that great day of the feast.
Okay, now, we're coming on down through this post-illusion age. We're coming down here to the end of this post-illusion age where God himself comes in as the form of the sonship as we are in the form of the Savior. And we're coming down near the end, and Yahweh is in and fulfilled his purpose in the ministry here as Yahweh the Messiah. Now, read.
In the last day.
And he's speaking here. He says, in the last days. Read.
That great day of the feast.
Mm-hmm.
Joshua stood and cried out, saying, if any man thirst,
mm-hmm.
let him come unto me and drink.
Now, he's already said that he was that wellspring of water. He said, now, if any man thirst, then, let him come unto me.
Mm-hmm.
He that believeth on me.
And he that believeth.
As the scripture has said.
He that believeth, as the scripture that said, it was taught from the time that y'all have been in here, that the scripture he's referring to is the Old Testament. So he's saying that he that believeth, according to the scriptures, which was the Old Testament, that testified of Joshua the Messiah, because as he said now, that the Jews, that they searched the scriptures daily, and they thought they had eternal life, but he said they were testified.
Mm-hmm.
Read.
Out of his belly
mm-hmm.
shall flow rivers of living water.
Now, if he believed on Joshua the Messiah, as the scripture there said, then he says, out of that person's belly would flow rivers of living water. We know he's not talking about the liquid water. Flow rivers of living water. Read.
But this spoke he of the Spirit.
But this rivers of life that he's talking about, coming forth, he's not talking about his water of liquid. But he said, but what?
But this spoke he of the Spirit.
But he said, but this spake he of the Spirit.
Uh-huh.
Read.
Whom they that believe on
whom
him.
They, now he said, if you believe that the scripture that said. Now then, that they that believe, read.
Should receive.
Should receive.
For the Holy Spirit.
For the Holy Spirit, then.
Was not yet given.
Now, read why I took it that way is because, see, right from the time that man was created, Yahweh breathed breath of life into that man. He was body, soul, and spirit. But as it has in the scriptures, it is saying here from the time of Adam down to 4,000 years, when Yahshua the Messiah coming in, and Yahshua the Messiah, who is the Holy Spirit personified, he said that they that believe on him should receive the Holy Spirit, because he said that at that time, he said the Holy Spirit was not yet given. Yet the man has a spirit. He's body, soul, and spirit. He has a spirit, but God was saying 4,000 years later that the man was created, he said that Holy Spirit, which he's talking about, that prophesied in Joel that was to come, he said at that time they should receive, because at that time he said the Holy Spirit had not yet been given.
Mm-hmm.
Is that right? Now, I didn't say this, that's what the Messiah said. Now, read that over again so we make sure.
He that believeth on me.
He that believeth on me.
As the scripture has said.
As the scripture has said.
Out of his belly. belly shall flow rivers of living water.
Out of his belly then shall flow rivers of living water. Read.
But this spoke he of the Spirit.
But this spake he of the Spirit.
Whom they that believe on him should receive.
That they should receive.
For the Holy Spirit was not yet given.
Then he's saying, for at that time the Holy Spirit was not yet given. Now then, this same Joshua, who is the Holy Spirit personified, when you get over there in the 14th chapter of John, and start with about 14th chapter, and you're down about the 17th verse, or so, something like that.
John 14:16. And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comfort.
Okay, now John was speaking to the Jews. And he had told them, he said, now if you have believed on the Father, then also believe on me. Now then, as he is telling them this then, he said, now he told his disciples, he said, now I must go away. And if I go away, the Father will not leave you company. For the Father will send another comforter in my name. Now read.
And I will pray the Father.
And he said, and I will pray the Father. Read.
And he shall give you another comforter. And he may abide with you forever.
Now this comforter, the one he's talking about, he said that he shall abide with you forever.
Right.
Read.
Even the Spirit of truth.
Now then, here's the definition. He is defining what he is calling, what they are calling the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Now then, we find out what the definition is and what they're defining as the Holy Spirit. He's saying, this Comforter, whom the Father will send in my name, this Comforter, then he is the Spirit of truth. Now, if this is the case, this truth, this Spirit of truth whom they are designated, this Spirit that's coming in, this is that same Spirit that said, holy men of old spake that they were moved by the Holy Spirit. It was the truth in them that prophesied that the Savior was to come. It was the truth that prophesied of everything. But at that time, it said that even those men that spoke, and even the angels, it said they desired to look into the things of Yahweh, but it was hid from them. Now then, when you get out into it, it said even that Spirit that was within them signified, I'm talking about those prophets that prophesied of the salvation that was to come. Even those men who prophesied, they did not have the true understanding. Why is that? It's because of this. When Yahweh created this creation, and he brought it forth, and found himself like this, he thought within himself, we know that's just using words, thought within himself that he brought forth a creation. Now when he brought this creation in, the reason why and why things are going on the way they are, they said Yahweh had it locked up, regulated himself.
That's right. That's right.
There was a time, and he had a time when he would reveal his purpose.
That's right.
That's right.
So now if he's out of time that he would reveal it. It says even the why the creation, why things are going on the way they are, why the whole part, why is it going on like this? It was hid even from the angels.
Right.
And those men that prophesied that a Savior was to come, the Spirit within them signified, they wondered how and what manner this was going to come to pass, but it was hid from them. But they spoke under that Spirit of truth. That's the definition of that Holy Spirit. That is why I said now, when the Spirit of truth is coming. Read.
Even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive.
Now it said, even the Spirit of truth, and it said the world would receive it. That the world would embrace this truth when it came in. No, it said this Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot, it said the world cannot receive. Joshua is prophesied back here. We like to talk about words and that, talk about this and that. Now, the prophesied back in here, he said, Yahweh said, I will pour out of my Spirit upon all flesh. He didn't say him, he said all.
That's right.
Now, then, when he poured his Spirit out, those, he said, those that receive of my Spirit, then, he has the power to become the sons of Yahweh. So now, then, here he's saying here, Yahweh's purpose to put his Spirit within man, and that's why I said once you become conscious of this fact that the Holy Spirit is working in you, said, what know ye not then that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit.
Right.
Which you have, not of your own self, but which you have of God.
Right.
This is a gift of Yahweh. You didn't get this on your own, and even your body is not your own.
Right.
So it's just even worship Yahweh in your body and in your spirit, which belong to Him. But now, I said that the devil and everybody does not have the Holy Spirit, because the divine, what he's talking about sending in, he's talking about sending in the Spirit of truth.
Yes.
And this truth, he said, that the world would not receive it. The reason why he said they wouldn't receive it is because they know him not. Alright? Now get over in the 16th chapter and let's speak about that again. 16th to 17th chapter, they speak about the Spirit of truth.
16:7. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth.
Mm-hmm.
It is expedient for you that I go away.
That is Yahshua the Messiah now. He's telling those disciples whom he said he had handpicked. He said, you have not chosen me, but I have chosen you.
Right.
Now he's telling these disciples about him going away. And now he's telling them, read.
It is expedient for you that I go away.
Now it is expedient for you that I go away. Y'all listen to this. Yahshua said, I am the truth, I am the way and the life. Now then here he is, the truth, the way and the life. Now we talk about being personified in that one embodiment there. Now he's telling them, he said, it is expedient, or it is mandatory, that I go away in this form here. See?
For if I go not away,
mm-hmm.
the Comforter will not come unto you.
Mm-hmm.
But if I depart, I will send him unto you.
Mm-hmm.
And when he has come, he will reprove the world of sin.
Now he said that when the Spirit of truth is come, the Spirit of truth, this is what it will do. It will reprove the world of sin. I'm talking about the job. Talking about the truth. Don't you know the truth with the spell of lies?
That's right.
That's really why I'm talking about he'll destroy the satanic spirit, he'll destroy them with the brightness of his stomach.
Right.
Talking about preaching the truth. Man, tell a lie. If you tell a lie, you kind of keep trying to prop it up over here, you keep farther down, you're trying to prop it up. But when you tell the truth is done. Truth is factual.
Right.
And it goes on. So you have to try to prop the truth up. So then that's why I said, hey, he'll destroy it by the preaching of the truth gospel. I'm telling you, you will destroy that satanic doctrine that's sitting up here in our mind. You will tear it down.
That's right.
That's the only thing going to do it.
That's right.
And that's one of the reasons why that we have come out from all the other doctrines being taught and coming here, because the things we've heard in here has been proven to us.
All right.
That it's true.
Right.
And that's the reason why the founder said this. That's the reason why he wasn't afraid to have us to go out and listen to anybody else, to go listen to somebody.
That's right.
And also he could run us out of there.
That's right.
The reason why is he knew. And he stated a lot of times. He said, if you understand what I am teaching, he said, you will remain just like I mean.
That's right.
You're going to play. And I'm talking about knowing something for surety. I'm talking about this taking on shape and form. Well, when I'm talking about truth, I'm not talking about somebody said to you, your mother said, if you get up in your room today and you say, yes, Mother, I think up our room today. That's true. But that's not true we're talking about. Did you go to the store today? Yes, I went to the store today and I bought this and that. That's true. But that's not the truth we're talking about. Divine truth. So when you talk about theosophy, you talk about divine wisdom, you talk about that which is, talking about the wisdom, the knowledge, which is in of knowledge, which is already revealed to a select few. That truth is what Joshua Messiah said to the Jews. He said, don't you know that the truth shall set you free?
Right.
That's right.
And they told him, said, listen, we be in bondage to no man. And they didn't know that they were in bondage. They looking for some physical bondage. They know they was in bondage here. That's where we all been in bondage. Right up here. That's the reason why I'm talking about the truth is coming to tear down all strongholds and imaginations that man had. Right here. Tear down all the imaginations, opinions, and theories, and ideas, and tear right on down. The truth will do that.
Yeah.
Now, the Holy Spirit has a job to do. And the Holy Spirit said, when it has come, it will reprove the world of sin. Read.
And when he has come, he will reprove the world of sin, mm-hmm. and of righteousness, mm-hmm. and of judgment. Mm-hmm. Of sin, because they believe not on me.
Mm-hmm.
Of righteousness, because I go to the Father, and ye see me no more.
Now, because I go to the Father, you see me no more. May they understand. Had no way of knowing at that time that that was the Father manifested in that form there. But he talked about going and coming, going and coming. And he's saying it, that if I don't go away, take off this form here that he has on him. And he said, unless I go away, then he said, this comforter cannot come. Can't come. Read why he's the Spirit, he was the Holy Spirit personified in his physical form right there. So it says he's got to go away. What he's talking about is taking off that physical form, that form that came in the likeness of sinful flesh. So he's talking about taking that off.
Uh-huh.
Now when he does that then, now it's accomplished that you can have of his Spirit and I can have of it. But he said if it don't do that, he said, then the comforter can't come.
That's right.
Read.
A judgment, mm-hmm. because the prince of this world is judged.
Mm-hmm.
I have yet many things to say unto you, but ye cannot bear them now.
Mm-hmm.
Nevertheless, when he, the Spirit of truth, is
but come. When the Spirit of truth, now they keep talking about coming. Mm-hmm. And we're talking about over here this post-illuminate. And the reason why it said it, as Brendan and John has said, the Holy Spirit was not yet given, is because Christ was the Messiah and not been crucified yet. And so after his crucifixion, that's when that prophecy comes forth that he said, I will pour out of my Spirit on all flesh. That's when he comes to pass. After his death, burial, and resurrection, and ascension, and then the outpouring of that Holy Spirit. Now he talks about again here about the Spirit of truth.
Nevertheless, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come.
And the only reason why I said it's designated is being designated what they are saying the Holy Spirit is here. It's talking about the Spirit of truth. So then when the Spirit of truth is come, which he said the world cannot receive. So now when that is come, read.
He will guide you into all truth.
Mm-hmm.
For he shall not speak of himself,
mm-hmm.
but whatever he shall hear, that shall he speak.
Okay, so now, then, here's what I said. That the satanic spirit of the devil does not have the truth, because it doesn't have the Holy Spirit. It's because of this. In John, 8th chapter, and give me about the 40th verse or so.
John 8 and 40. But now you seek to kill me.
But maybe go ahead and get some continuity thoughts.
8:32. Well. 33. I'll cover
32. Okay.
And ye shall know the truth.
Uh-huh.
And the truth shall make you free.
Read.
They answered him, we are Abraham's seed.
Mm-hmm.
And we're never in bondage to any man.
Now see, that makes you stop and think right here. Look. Now, they, the Jews, having come down from that nation of Abraham, they figured that they were righteous and they were to be saved just because they were of Abraham's seed.
Uh-huh.
And so when he was saying that, they said, look, they're boasting now, we be of Abraham. Read.
How sayest thou, ye shall be made free?
Mm-hmm.
Yahweh answered them, verily, verily, I say unto you,
mm-hmm.
whosoever committeth sin is the servant of sin.
Mm-hmm.
And the servant abideth not in the house forever,
mm-hmm.
but the Son abideth there. If the Son therefore shall make you free, ye shall be free indeed.
Read.
I know that ye are Abraham's seed,
mm-hmm.
but ye seek to kill me, because my word hath no place in you.
Mm-hmm.
I speak that which I have seen with my Father, and ye do that which you have seen with your Father.
All right.
They answered and said unto him, Abraham is our father.
Mm-hmm.
Joshua said unto them, if ye were Abraham's children, you would do the works of Abraham.
Now then, look. Abraham, he believed.
That's right.
It said Abraham didn't have no righteousness of his own, neither does anybody else.
That's right.
In the book of Romans it said there is none righteous, no, not one.
Right.
That includes anybody you can talk about, including the mother Mary. So now when you come down through it, it said from Adam all the way down, there is none righteous, no, not one. And you get out here and got the Messiah, and they tried to even That's why he's a good master. He said, why callest thou me good? He said, there is none good except the Father.
That's right.
And they were looking at this physical form that he was manifesting, which is, he took the sins of the world upon himself. But now here he said, read.
But now you seek to kill me.
And as I said before, see, Abraham just believed Yahweh, and it was accounted unto him for righteousness.
Mm-hmm.
Now then, if you believe, that's the reason why I said up here today, okay, it's no different, no different than it was back at Abraham's time. It said, if you just believe, it will be accounted unto you for righteousness. And that's what it said up here, just believe. According to the Scripture, that don't mean just
believe anything.
See, a lot of times we like to say, if a man don't teach according to the law of the prophets, there's no light in him. You gotta quantify that. There's a man that teaches according to the law of the prophets, guided by the Holy Spirit.
Right.
Oh, here you got some of the people out here trying to grab up some of the law of the prophets too.
Yeah.
Read.
But now you seek to kill me,
mm-hmm.
a man which has told you the truth,
mm-hmm.
which I have heard of Yahweh. This did not Abraham.
Mm-hmm.
Ye do the works of your father. Then said they unto him, we are not born of fornication.
Mm-hmm.
We have one father, even Yahweh.
So now Joshua said, I do the will of my father. And he's telling them, you also are doing the will of your father. But the father he was talking about was not the one that they were thinking about. Like that quotation. I know you think you understand what you heard.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
But I'm not sure that you don't understand that what you heard was not what I said. That means when I said something, you thought I said one thing, I said something else.
That's right.
So what you heard was not what I said. So now he's talking about one thing, he's talking about something else. He's talking about the father's life. This is that here, he's talking about the father's life. And they think he's talking about Abraham. They said, look, we have Abraham to our father. He said, you are not doing the work of Abraham. Read.
Joshua said unto them,
mm-hmm.
if Yahweh were your father, you would love me.
Mm-hmm.
For I proceeded forth and came from Yahweh.
Read.
Neither came I of myself, but he sent me.
Uh-huh.
Why do you not understand my speech? Even because you cannot hear my words.
Mm-hmm.
You are of your father, the devil.
That's right.
Of your father. The devil. He said, why is it you don't understand my speech? Is it because you don't hear what I say? But it wasn't hard to hear it. And the Father would say, you heard me, you ain't blind.
That's right. Yeah, that's right.
And I said, what is he talking about? Nobody heard me, you ain't blind. He wasn't talking about hearing when you this ear here. Blind to the truth. Read.
Ye are of your father, the devil,
mm-hmm.
and the lust of your father you will do.
Mm-hmm.
He was a murderer from the beginning.
That said now, Satan, or the satanic spirit, he said that he was, as the Messiah here saying, he said he was a liar and a murderer right from the beginning. He was the one that called and spoke to the angels out of heaven. He was the one that called the downfall of Adam here in the Garden of Eden and right on down. So he said, now you, this is that old satanic spirit. He is a liar and a murderer right from the beginning. Read.
And abode not in the truth.
Wait a minute. He said, when the spirit of truth is come, talking about the reality of things, the understanding of why the things are going on, the esoteric secrets of Scripture, which is John when he was back on the Isle of Patmos, when he said that he saw the seven those seals set on, and he said the heaven was searched and the earth was searched, there wasn't no man to find the
right.
A whip that owned the seal. And he said he began to cry, but the angel told him, don't weep, John. Why would we? Because see, there is someone who can open those seals.
That's right.
Open the book and lose the seal. And that is understanding business and secrets. The only way you're going to understand it is that the Father will have to give us an understanding of it.
Right.
Even one that opens these things up.
Right.
Even one that's got to close up.
That's
right.
That's the reason why old man said, he said, you can sit the person down and talk to him till you're blue in the face.
That's right.
And if Yahweh don't give him no understanding, he don't understand.
Right.
What are you talking about? That means you're not going to give it that man to understand. You're not going to lose these seals. You're not going to open the book. It's going to take the Holy Spirit to do that, or the Father.
He was a murderer from the beginning, and abode not in the truth.
Now he said, when the Spirit of truth come, that's me while I'm saying that. He wasn't Yahweh, and not, when he talked about the Holy Spirit is coming, he's not talking about the Spirit, his Spirit is man. He's talking about the Spirit of truth, because I know that everything is emanated right back here from pure Spirit too. Now then, he said, now, this one, this was that experience, said, he abides not in the truth. Read.
Because there is no truth in him.
Now then, if the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of truth, and he said that the Spirit abides not in the truth, he said, because there is no truth in him, then that's why I said that the Satanic Spirit does not have the Holy Spirit. Because we're talking about what he's designating is, that the Spirit of truth, as it said right here, he does not have the truth abiding within him. When you get over there in Corinthians, speaks about divine mysteries and all this, that we speak wisdom. He is in a mystery, which the carnal mind cannot and don't understand.
That's right.
So I ain't quoting this right.
In 1 Corinthians 2, starting at the 9th verse. 1 Corinthians 2 and 9. But as it is written, I have not seen nor ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man the things which Yahweh has prepared for them that love him. But Yahweh hath revealed them unto us by his Spirit.
Now they said that he has revealed these things unto us, how that? By his Spirit. So this is, if you know anything about the mystery first of Yahweh, you did not get it from man.
That's correct.
Though you might saw somebody standing up before you, but that person standing up before you certainly did not give you the understanding.
That's right.
So then, that's the reason why I said this we talk about is hidden in the mystery. Read.
For the Spirit searcheth all things, yea, the deep things of Yahweh.
For the Spirit. And he said, but that which may be known of Yahweh, yea, even though deep, esoteric, secret, and mystery of Yahweh, it says the Spirit searches all things. Spirit does. Read.
For what man knoweth the things of a man, save the spirit of the man which is in him?
Now you know something about a man. When it said man, it's talking about mankind. That includes women. You know something about other people because you are the human race. So it said, what spirit, what knows the things of the man except the spirit of man in him? Now we know things of man because we're that's where we are. Read.
Even so, the things of Yahweh knows no man, but the Spirit of Yahweh.
But the Spirit of Yahweh.
Now we have received.
And we used to miss it. And we used to miss it. The fountain sat on the floor and he said, no man knows anything about the perfect plan of Yahweh except Yahweh himself.
That's right.
Right.
And then go about this plan. And we missed it. But that is, he said, laid it out plain. No man knows anything about the perfect plan of Yahweh except Yahweh himself. And then he went about to explain it. Well, then, what did that tell you? That has to be Yahweh doing it. If nobody, no man knows it, nobody knows it, but Yahweh, he tells anybody, that has to be Yahweh doing the telling. Read.
Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the Spirit which is of Yahweh, that we might know the things that are freely given to us of Yahweh, which things also we speak, not in the words which man wisdom teaches, but which the Holy Spirit teaches, comparing spiritual things with spiritual. But the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of Yahweh.
Now listen to this. It says, when the Spirit of truth is up, he will even guide you in all righteousness. Now, he's talking about the Satanic Spirit. I'm talking about, I'm not talking about the Spirit. I'm talking about what he designated as the Spirit of Truth, and what they call the Holy Spirit. So, then, when I said his designation, I'm not talking about the Spirit he put in man, and yet I know what's in man from the very, very, from the very beginning. But as we talk about designation, and he's talking about designated when that Spirit of truth has come, because he's talking about, if you read it, the Bible said that it hadn't come yet, and that's Yahshua the Messiah said it hadn't come yet, and he said when the Spirit of truth has come, then he would lead you and guide you to all right. God said that satanic spirit, he said, he does not abide in the truth, neither does he know it. And there's no truth in him. So if the designated man that the Holy Spirit is the spirit of truth, then it said he doesn't have spirit. Neither does he have truth. Now that we're talking about man now, you know, talk about carnal mind. See?
But the natural man.
Mm-hmm. But the natural man. We talk about the spirit which is only the wisdom which is only from Yahweh. Now we get down to talking about the natural man, the carnal man. See?
But the natural man
mm-hmm.
receiveth not the things of the spirit of Yahweh.
Now when he says when the Holy Spirit has come, which the world will not receive, then that's not receiving is those that have a carnal mind. We probably saying here, putting it together here, he's saying here that read the natural man.
But the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of Yahweh.
So then the natural man, he will not receive the things of Yahweh. Read.
For they are foolishness unto him.
Mm-hmm.
Neither can he know them.
He can't know them.
Because they are spiritually discerned.
Then he doesn't have the truth. Now, I want to tell you, go ahead and grab up somebody. You say, everybody got the truth. Then go ahead and grab up somebody. Tell them, explain to you the mysteries and purpose and plan of Yahweh. They don't have the truth out there. And you have to sit in some of these schools where Yahweh has given us an understanding, and he is going to speak it to come into this mystery, come into this knowledge, because everybody out there don't have it. It's because he even prophesied in the book of Amos. And he said that there shall be a famine in the land. In Amos 8 chapter. There shall be a famine in the land. Hey, when you talk about shell, we over in that shell now.
Yeah, that's right.
Now, there shall be a famine in the land, but you talk about this famine that we're talking about. It's not a famine of bread nor of water, of earth and water. But it shall be of hearing the truth. So now you can go and preach the truth. You can go and preach the truth to men, and men will reject it, just like they did Joshua Messiah. When he comes along, he's the Holy Spirit personified. He comes to his own people, and it said his own received him not. But then here he is, he's coming to bring salvation to the Jews. This is the King of Glory, and what do? They reject him. Read why they rejected him, because they couldn't see past the flesh.
That's right.
And then he looked just like us, so then he can be a king. So when they look for a king to come, and they look for somebody to come with 10,000 men, and when he come in, they didn't see that heavenly host that was with him, so then they say, he ain't nobody. Say, who was he? That Mary Joseph's son. Says, he was born up there in Nazareth. They just come out of Nazareth, just like they talk about cities now, Cleveland, New Jersey. They say, what you do come out of Cleveland, New Jersey, somewhere. That's the same way they talk about the city he came out of. They didn't say nothing good ever come out of Nazareth. But see, they couldn't see. They were blind. Like I said, when they read Moses today, they said this, they blind because the flesh still hanging in their eyes.
That's right.
That's the reason why they couldn't see the spirit in him but looking at that body.
That's right.
That goes on all the time. They said they will hate you because they hated me. And they don't know me, they won't know you.
Right.
You walk down the street, Yahweh touch your heart, seal you with that Holy Spirit of promise. You walk down the street, somebody look at you and say, that old no good so-and-so.
Yeah.
Can't see what's in you. Because you got all the barrier, which is the flesh. Same way with him. So now then, talking about that carnal minded man then, you try to, and I've seen them take men and sit them down. I'm talking about the founding others. Sit men down and just try to show them step by step by step how this thing works. And when they get through with it, men they don't want to believe it. Soon they got through it all that time. So what are they doing then? They're rejecting the truth. And they don't agree why they reject it, because they don't see it. And that's the reason why he try to tell somebody, look, you don't have to be baptized in over here this thing to be saved. That sound is as foreign to them as anything all of you want to say. But they're rejecting the truth. And the truth is, Joshua the Messiah, then he had paid the price. and he died after old boy got to be the savior of the world. But if you listen, you got almost saved yourself. And it's pathetic, because it's just like, I was reading in the newspaper today, I think it was Ann Lentz, or Dear Addie, you know. The woman said that years ago her husband left her, and he beat her up, put her in the hospital, and left her, and left these kids and all. And she said while she was in the hospital, the priest came and talked to her. And the priest told her, said, you just pray and ask God to help you. He said, but God can't do it by himself. He needs your help. As the man told the woman, he said, God cannot do it alone. He needs your help. I want to know, where were you at when he brought the creation in? Now, what kind of God is this one going to have? Brought the creation in town and me, where were you? Where were you when I said you wouldn't? I brought forth this and that. Where were you? You wasn't nowhere around. You ain't got no. God ain't going to need no help. You talk about it, you can't do it alone. You need some help to do it. That's sad. That's beautiful. And that's the way the world thinks. Well, he's the savior of the world, but we need to help him save us. See? That's the way it is. As they say, if he was alive, he walked on by him one in front of him, now walk around. A lot of these churches, he couldn't join. They wouldn't even accept that. He wouldn't measure up. Wouldn't measure up. Okay, so now it says any carnal minded man, then he does not receive the things of the Spirit. Reason why it said it's because they are spiritually discerned. In other words, it has to be the Holy Spirit to give us an understanding. So then this truth is known. Because see, in this age here, it says, mysteries and secrets of power. It said they were in these other ages. They were hid, but now they have been revealed over here by the Spirit. So since they were hid over here in these other ages, now the Spirit of truth has come. And when the truth is coming, it's preached to you. And this is falling on you. And when that truth is preached, and if you receive it in your heart and your mind, then that is the Holy Spirit revealing unto you that the Lord is coming in your heart. Oh, I tell you, you're talking about. You talk about the law. Talk about something that you ain't strained up trying to do. It's leading and guiding you. When the law is leading and guiding us, then we're not doing any and everything. Then that means then you're not condemned about what you do. It's not what you're doing, it's what the Spirit is leading and guiding you doing. Because Paul said, hey, I am dead. Since I know and understand I am dead, he said, yet I live. Listen, that's a contradictory statement. I am dead, yet I live. That's a contradictory statement. But then he turned around and said, it's not me to live it, but it's Joshua the Messiah that lives in me. And though I am still living in the flesh, I live by the grace of the Son of God. So I'm living in the flesh, but I ain't living for myself anymore. I'm living for Joshua the Messiah. So I'm dead to myself, but I'm alive unto him. See, I'm telling you, when you talk about when this truth, you talk about any old kind of truth, you talk about when this truth is sealed within you, this is what will sustain you, will let you endure persecution, will let you endure people farther away from friends and all farther away, even going to death, being put to death. I'm talking about something real. Being put to death, get saved, carry on through. So now then, as I said before, now this is what he designated the Spirit of Truth. And he's talking about what is come, the world won't receive. And you know that, carrying truth all over the world, this institution has sent men all over all the world. And what did they do? Carry this doctrine. Forget it, reject it. So then they carry it, say they won't receive it. The reason why they won't receive it, because they said they don't see it. So now that's what we're talking about. And that is what we're talking about, that Spirit of truth in you. That is the Holy Spirit. That is the thing that sustains and guides and leads you throughout all this age. That is the thing that was talking about Joshua in you, the Messiah in you. That's the thing that's going to change you, because because of the statement that within him that kept him. Now, give me this, then I'll be proof. Now look. Joshua charged his disciples, Matthew 28:19. He charged his disciples. Let me say this first. John, when John was baptized, denied him in the river Jordan. And he baptized the body of Joshua the Messiah in fulfillment of the baptism of Moses and the children of Israel. Now here's what John said. John said, I truly baptize in water. Don't get nervous, because I'm going to be here as much time as I take. Now, he said, I indeed baptize you with water. He said, but he that cometh after me, he shall baptize you with the fire and the Holy Ghost. Is that right?
That's right.
Now, he was speaking of Joshua the Messiah. John was. John said, I indeed baptize you with water, but there comes one after me who shall baptize you with the fire and with the Holy Ghost.
Right.
Now then, in the so-called Great Commission, Joshua the Messiah took those 12 men he had chosen to follow him around, to be his disciples. Now, he charged them, and he told them, read,
go ye, this is Matthew 28:19.
Mm-hmm.
Go ye therefore and teach all nations.
Go ye therefore and teach all nations. Read.
Baptizing them in the name of the Father.
Baptizing them in the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Teaching them
mm-hmm.
to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you.
Mm-hmm.
And lo, I am with you always,
mm-hmm.
even unto the end of the world.
Now look, he is the Spirit personified. And he is telling his disciples whom he charged going to all the world, teaching, baptizing in the name. And lo, I am with you always, even to the end. Now this Spirit of truth, when it has come, which back here men prophesied unto, men spoke under the influence of that Spirit, even John the Baptist. John the Baptist had that Spirit, and it said it. He baptized the body of Joshua the Messiah. Then later on, the Spirit had left him, the Spirit of truth had left him, and then now he's wondering if Joshua the Messiah was the one that shouldn't look for another. But now he's telling them over here, then that Spirit of truth shall abide forever. This is talking about Joshua the Messiah. He said, I won't leave you this time, but I will abide with you forever. And that's what we're talking about, that Spirit. That's the one we're talking about. Look, once you know and understand this truth, I'm talking about when you know it.
Right.
When you really know it,
right.
This truth will never leave you.
That's right.
It will never leave you.
That's
the reason why I said the founder didn't worry about us. He said, if you understand,
that's right.
You know, if you don't understand, you can be swayed and gone on somewhere. But he said, if you understand what I have taught you, he said, then you will remain.
That's right.
He said a lot of times, this train don't go no further.
That's right.
So now that truth, once that truth is sealed in you, then it said it will abide forever. It don't make no difference when somebody come along and tell you. It don't make no difference when somebody come along and preach to you. Hey, this truth will remain.
That's right.
That's the thing of fact. That's the thing that holds, leads, guides you in the way of righteousness.
All right.